Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll show you how to work with cards in the Syncfusion Blazor Kanban component. I will also show you how to set the headers, content, and left border color, and use custom classes, selection types, and drag and drop. Let's start with the coding part. I'll open my existing example, where the Kanban component is configured, to show software development work in progress. If you want to learn how to create a basic Blazor WebAssembly app and add a Syncfusion component, refer to the video linked in the card above or in the description below. Let me run this application. Here you can see the Kanban board is rendered with empty cards. Let's see how to display data in the Kanban cards. First, I include the Kanban card settings. Then, to add the card header, I include the header field property and assign the title field from the task details list. To add the card content, I include the content field property and assign the summary field from the task details list. Look at the output. The Kanban cards are populated with data. The title is shown at the top of the card, and the summary is shown in the content area. I can also show tags in Kanban cards. To do that, I include the tags field property and assign the card tags field from the task details list. Check the Kanban now, and tags are shown in the cards. There is an option called Show Header, allows us to show or hide the card header. By default, this option is set to true to show the card header. So, to hide the header, I set false to the Show Header option. Check the Kanban cards, and the header is not shown. By default, I can drag and drop cards in a Kanban board. To prevent it, I include the Allow Drag and Drop property and set its value to false. Checking now, I can't drag the Kanban cards. Now I will show you how to customize the left border color of Kanban cards. I simply include the Grabber field property and map it to the color field from the task details list. I will also enable the Show Header property to improve readability. Enable Allow Drag and Drop property too. You can see the left side of the cards is customized with colors. To customize the entire card, refer to the video linked in the card above or in the description below. Next, I will show you how to add a custom element to the Kanban card footer using the Footer CSS field property. You can add images or icons to the card footer. Right now, I will add only icons to the cards to depict the task type. I include the Footer CSS field property in the Kanban card settings and map the class name field from the task details list. Include the style element and add the icons for the task types, story, bug, and improvement. You can find these icon details with the demo sample link in the below description. Then, add styles to align the card footer element and its icon. Checking the Kanban board, the icons were added to each card footer based on the task type. Finally, I'll show you the selection options available for Kanban cards: none, single, and multiple. By default, I can select only one card at a time. To perform multiple card selection, include the selection type property in the Kanban card settings and set its selection type to multiple. Now, I can perform multiple card selection either using the control key and mouse click action or the shift key and mouse click action. When the selection type is set to none, I can't select any cards on the Kanban board. In summary, we have seen how to work with cards and some of their features in the Syncfusion Blazor Kanban component in this video. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.